الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم، حمدا لا يتناهى. ملء السماوات السبع وملء الأرض السبع وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، وصل على محمد في الآخرين، وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين، وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. يقول الحق تبارك وتعالى في قرآنه الكريم: الذين آمنوا ولم يلبسوا إيمانهم بظلم أولئك لهم الأمن وهم مهتدون. In this آية من القرآن سورة الأنعام سورة نمبر 6 فيرس نمبر 82 الله عز وجل saying: those who believe and they did not confuse their iman with any kind of dhulm, with any kind of, in this ayah especially, dhulm here was meaning shirk. Because when this ayah at the beginning revealed the sahaba, they said, Ya Rasulullah, who of us will be having iman without any kind of wrong? They think that the dhulm, any kind of mistake. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah meaning this ayah shirk. Those people, Allah said, if you have your iman and you avoid the shirk, they have the security. They will be safe. They will be protected. And Allah said, and they are the rightly guided. Means other than the shirk is forgiven. But I am known, my khutbah is not about the shirk. This time I already, alhamdulillah, explained it. This khutbah, inshallah, I'm going on with dhulm. The land now, the earth from east to the west, from north to the south, full of dhulm. Either for your own self, by your own self, or against the other country to country, and a lot. Doesn't need an explanation. For that, the topic is very important. Where the dhulm, the lam, mean? Have many translation wrongdoing, but I'm coming to the definition of dhulm. What it is. In general, there is limit set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any transgress of any limit set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is zulm. Either against your own self or against others. But I need every one of you now to know three words. In order, while I'm going with this topic or with a series of it, to know what I'm talking about. Three words very important. The one who do wrong is zalim. The one who do any wrong against himself or against other is zalim. The thing done itself, the wrongdoing itself, is dhulm. The one you do against him, mazlum. For that, these three words are very important. Because I will repeat it going on. Zalim is the wrongdoer. The thing he do wrong is dhulm. The one he do against, suppose he beat somebody, this man become mazlum, means he is wronged, wrong or oppression done against him. In the Quran al-Kareem, Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned the word of dhulm with the roots and the branches, in Arabic with al-mushtaqat 315 times. In the Quran only, in the Sunnah more than this. Because of the importance of avoiding it. And clarification from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to it, Allah repeated in the Quran 315 times in the Quran al-Kareem. And in the Sunnah a lot also. Imam al-Dhahabi, which I'm going with the series of the major sin. Imam al-Dhahabi, he counted the kabair, the major sin. He make dhulm kabira number 26. And I'm going in it, subhanallah, coming the same time. I'm going in it right now. And I'm a middle or the last part of it, of the Kabira number 26. And he explained for it usually explain 2-3 pages about any kabir or 4-5 pages. In Zulm, more than 13-14 pages completely about the Zulm because of the importance of avoiding it and knowing it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran al-Kareem also, فَقُطِعَ دَابِرُ الْقَوْمِ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cut off also not only the people who is doing Zulm, not only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroys them, no, and also the traces of them and whatever they are doing, all of it will be gone. And praise be to Allah for that. In Surah Luqman, Surah number 31, verse number 13, Allah Azza wa Jal, when he mentioned about Sayyidina Luqman advising his son and all of us also, said, Ya Bunay, La tushrik billah. إن الشرك لظلم لظلم عظيم. Oh my son, never commit any kind of shirk. The shirk is associated only worship with Allah, anything else is a great sin. In Surah An-Nisa, Surah number 4, verse number 10, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about the orphan, because sometimes the orphan have no father or mother doesn't know, and the one who take care of him swallow everything, and he say, "Oh, I didn't see nothing." Allah said, "Inna al-ladina yakulun amwal al-yatama zulman. Inna ma yakulun fi butunihim nara, wa sayaslawun sa'ira." Those who eat the property or the money of the yatim, the orphan, they are eating it and are doing zulm against their own self, and they are eating in their belly, jahannam, nar, fire. And they will be forever, and they will go Jahannam. In Surah An-Nisa also, Surah number 4, verse number 30, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, do not eat or do not take or do not do any wrong of the, against the money of the others. And when he talk about do not commit any kind of killing of any other one, he said, وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ means whoever do any one of this, عدوانه وظلما فسوف نصليه نارا وكان ذلك على الله يسيرا. Whoever doing that by transgress the limits by Allah, which it is a definition of ظلم, and doing also even عدوان itself is very clear what Allah confirmed. عدوانا وظلم, and it is ظلم, Allah will make him to go to fire, and this is easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah An-Nahl, Surah number 16, verse number 61, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about all and everyone in this ayah. Everyone. Because everyone has some mistakes. No one is perfect except Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and whom Allah wants. For that here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, وَلَوْ يُؤَاخِذُ اللَّهُ النَّاسَ بِظُلْمِهِمْ مَا تَرَكَ عَلَيْهَا مِنْ دَابَّةِ ولكن يؤخرهم إلى أجل مسمى. If Allah account everyone about his mistake, he will never leave anyone alive in this world. Remember when I said one time that we are 7 billion. If everyone mistake in one mistake a day, if it's not more, one mistake a day from 7 billion, this is 7 billion mistake a day going. If Allah account us about that, he will never leave anyone alive. For that here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, but Allah say, I'm delaying them to a point of time. They will come to account at the day of judgment. This is about the zulm itself, about the zalim, the one who do. Listen in Surah Shu'ara, Surah number 26, verse number 227. Allah said, وَسَيَعْلَمُ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا أَيَّ مُنْقَلَبٍ يَنْقَلِبُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warning everyone, saying that if you have a power, Allah has the most powerful. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you think that you can do wrong against him, fear Allah Azza wa Jalla and remember. Position or a power or politics or whatever it is, save yourself. Allah say, those who do dhulm, they will come to know for which return they will be returned. Which return, which way? Jannah or Jahannam? There is no need of Jahannam, walayyazu billah. And they will ask for delaying them or let them go back to the worldly life. And in the hereafter, no dinar, no dirham to pay. Only الحسنات والسيئات, good deeds and bad deeds. And only is a good reward you have, or if you don't have, they will take from their bad sin and put it upon you. Because there is no dirham to pay, there is no money, no dollars. Only as Rasulullah coming, the ayat and ahadith about that a lot. That in the day of judgment will be the justice done by good deeds and bad deeds. Equal to whatever wrong you do to against him. Doesn't matter what it is. Small will be taken little equal to it. Big will be taken. Suppose all of yours finished, then will be taken from the one who you do wrong against him. His sin will be put upon you. Then after that, as the hadith coming later, inshallah, a man will come in front of Allah with a lot of good deeds. Hajjan, sadaqan, salan, mu'amalat, a lot of hasanat kamsad al-jibal. Good deeds equal to the mountains. But at the end, he will be thrown to hellfire. Why? Because he did wrong against this one, and he backbited this one, and he took money of this one, and he killed this one, and he did wrong. All of this kind of, different kind of dhulm. You will pay from your good deeds to them. If it is finished, will be taken from their bad deeds, from their sin, will be put upon the person who does dhulm, then he will be thrown to Jahannam. In Surah Ash-Shura, Allah explained more. Surah number 42, ayah number 44. وَتَرَى الظَّالِمِينَ لَمَّا رَأَوْا الْعَذَابَ يَقُولُونَ هَلْ إِلَى مَرَدٍ مِّن سَبِيلٍ. Allah Azza wa Jal say, you will see the zalim at the day of Qiyamah, someone who do wrong against anybody. He will say, oh Allah, is there any way to go back to the dunya? I will do good. Is there any way to go back to the dunya? For that, this is a warning to us. Instead of you coming the day of judgment and ask Allah, oh Allah, let me go back and I will do good. Now is the time. Now is the time. And this reminder from Allah and from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to everyone have some of the iman. That, yes, you will be feel disgraced if you do zulm or wrong against anyone. But the disgracing of dunya, nothing comparing in the akhirah. Right? Suppose when you ask somebody, oh, forgive me, I did this wrong against you, sometimes very heavy on you. And you will feel that you will put yourself down, no, I'm not doing, let him go to hell. No, he is not going. Yeah, the one who does zulm, the one who does wrong, is the one who will go. But you will never realize that, except in the hereafter when you see the punishment. Do not wait till this time. This warning from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us, wake up. To wake us up in order to know now is the time. And even disgraced in this time, better than to come in front of Allah at the day of judgment, and then will be no way. In Surah Al-Kahf, Surah number 18, verse number 29, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, Inna a'tadna lil-zalimina nara ahata bihim suradiquha. Allah said, we prepared hellfire to those zalim, and will be surround them inside it, walls of Jahannam. The walls of Jahannam will be surrounding them. No way to get out of it. No way. For that I said at the beginning, there is zalim, the one who do wrong, and there is mazloom. Being mazloom in Islam better than being zalim, but with the sabr. With the sabr and being patient. Otherwise, do not be zalim. Why? In Surah Hud, Surah number 11, verse number 18, Allah said, Ala لعنة الله على الظالمين. لعنة of Allah, the curse of Allah upon the zalim. And when the curse of Allah catch anybody, there is no universal. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking also not about her, talk about the zulm itself, and some ayat about the zalim. And there is ayat also about the one who the wrong done against him, mazloom. In Arabic, mazloom or those who zulimu, wrong done against them, the oppression. Surah An-Nahl, Surah 16, verse number 41, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا فِي اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا ظُلِمُوا لَنُبَوِّئَنَّهُمْ فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَلَأَجْرُ الْآخِرَةِ أَكْبَرُ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ. If the zulm done against some people until they migrate, they leave the place to them. You know, sometimes when you say to some people, Ya akhi, not only I will leave the country to you, I will leave another country beside it in order to be far from you. وَلَيَعْزُ بِاللَّهِ. Because some people is professional in evil. For that Allah here subhanahu wa ta'ala said, about those who was wronged, the wrong done against them, مظلوم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, I will give them better in dunya, and in al-akhirah, the reward is greatest, if they know. In Surah An-Nisa, Allah allow you to express the dhulm, if it happened against you. In Surah An-Nisa, Surah number 4, verse number 148, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لا يحب الله الجهر بالسوء من القول إلا من ظلم وكان الله سميعا عليما. Allah does not like that any evil should be uttered. Allah does not like you to say any kind of evil in public except by whom, by him who has been wronged. Except if the one who was wronged, this one Allah allow him to say what's wrong happened against him from the other one. Let us move now to another part at the same related. That I said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repeat the word dhulm in Quran 315 times. And it is kabira in Imam al-Zahabi and other different number. But in Imam al-Zahabi 26. For that let us go to now there is Allah mentioned in Al-Quran al-Kareem 9 different meaning to the zulm. In the Quran al-Karim, if you look to the ayat, you'll find the word zulm have 9 different meaning. Let us go one by one. Firstly, let us go with the definition of zulm. What it is? قال الإمام العيني الظلم ضد العدل. Zulm is against justice. Because one of them, either justice, عدل, fair, right, or العزو بالله the opposite. Zulm and wrong and haram, because both of them cannot be in one. وأصله مجاوزة الحد والتصرف في ملك الغير ووضع الشيء في غير موضعه والتعدي والتطاول دون رضا من يفعل ذلك عنه. He said, the original of it is transgress the limit, and this limit set by Allah, either in money or against the other, or against your own self, and also in another definition, putting the thing in different than its place, is a kind of dhulm. Putting anything not in its place. Anything you put it not in its place, not in its time, is a kind of dhulm. For that here, this definition is having some. وَالظَّلَمَةُ المانعون أهل الحق حقوقهم. The ظالم is the one who prevent the right to reach to the person should have it. This is kind of ظلم. والظلم صور. ظلم is many types. أكل أموال الآخرين. Taking the property or the money of the other. Kind of ظلم. سلب حقوقهم. Does not giving them the right. Kind of ظلم. انتزاع ممتلكاتهم, taking anything belong to them, even a مسواك, is a kind of ظلم. جرح مشاعر, because there is also Imam al-Zahabi, he explained about does the ظلم should be only in a big things or even a small. Rasulullah already said, ولو كان عودا من أراك. Is it even you do wrong against somebody in a مسواك, is only clean your teeth with it. جرح مشاعر الناس ظلم. Disgracing other and putting them down and make them look bad and looking for their fault, kind of zulm. The kind of zulm also, kind of wrong and haram and forbidden. مس كرامة الناس ظلم والغيبة والنميمة ظلم. غيبة and backbiting and transfer the word with a bad intention to create problem, kind of zulm. والتعريض بالآخرين والانتقاص منهم ظلم. When you have a disease in your heart, Muslim should love everyone, Muslim or not, believer or not, as long as it's not against Allah, not against Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if you have some disease in the heart, this will make you to go against everybody, walayaz billah. For that, putting down the other should be clear to everyone. Whoever put the other down have disease in his heart, should not. Allah make us not perfect. Allah does not make us, no one is perfect. For that, some of the things in everybody is good, Some of the things in everyone is not good. Try with a good intention and with a good advice to deal with the good and also to correct with a good and with the hikmah and with a nice way and with the sabr whatever is wrong. Also, طمس الحقائق ظلم. طمس الحقائق means what? You know the truth about something. You hide it. You don't want to say it. Do you know Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم saying one dua also against this kind of view? اللهم إني أعوذ بك من خليل ماكر عينه تراني وقلبه يرعاني إن رأى حسنة دفنها وإن رأى سيئة أذاعها والعياذ بالله. What the meaning of it? Rasulullah himself used to say in the hadith in Bukhari, Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from anyone who looked to me by his eye and he looks like a friend to me, but his heart is boiling from me. His heart is not clean about me. His heart hates me. His heart doesn't like me. For that, whatever good he see, because he look, whatever good he see, he will hide it. He actually, the word saying, إن رأى حسنة دفنها. Do you know دفنها means bury it alive. If he see any good, he will bury it. وإن رأى سيئة أذاعها. And if he see any wrong, he will express it. And he will spread it. And he will go to the people talk against you. This kind of disease in the heart, hypocrisy. Muslims should not have that. Clean your heart. Remember when I talk about the tahara and purification? And I said the wudu and the shower, cleaning from outside. Salah should be cleaning from inside. Looking and digging behind the mistakes of the other and waiting. Tarabbus bin nas. Waiting. Kind of zulm. Wait if he felt something, little. Catch it and then do. A'uzu billah, ya akhi. A'uzu billah, what is this? You do not think that you are, does not have any? You have. For that, save yourself in order for Allah to save you also. And the original is follow what Allah say, follow what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say. خداع الناس ظلم. Types of ظلم also. When you betray others, when you cheat them, saying something and doing something else. Muslim should not do that at all. أقول قولي هذا ودعو الله وأنتم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. Types of ظلم also. احتقار الآخرين ظلم. Looking down to the others and feeling that you are higher than them. Kind of ظلم. والربا ظلم. Riba, or any kind, name it, beautiful names now, interest and whatever, all of it kind of zulm, which transgresses the limit set by Allah. Allah say riba is haram, people say no Allah. Riba is halal and not. Zina is halal as haram, or girlfriend and boyfriend, no problem, protected by the law. A'uzu billah, ya. Also, sihr. Sihr, black magic, and any related to it, including, what's the name of it, scope, something, scope. Horoscope exercise. Yes, horoscope and reading about it and deciding according to it. Kind of magic. Haram in Islam. And I already explained about that. Horoscope, you are traveling today, then by suddenly, you open the newspaper, yes, do not travel today, calamity will happen upon your head. Don't believe all of this. Nobody knows ghaib except Allah Azza wa Jalla. Nobody knows ghaib except Allah. And this is kind of black magics. Part of it is not what you... Because sometimes we know the black magic or sihr or whatever you name in your language with only some certain kind. But in Islam, there is a branches for everything. And explained very well. Believe in Allah, trust Allah, depend upon Allah. Do not make your decision according to that. Make your decision according to... There is istikhara in Islam. You fear? Do istikhara. Two rak'ah and the du'a. Oh Allah, I ask you by your power, by your knowledge. This is better. Billions of billions, unlimited time. Then depending upon something like that. عقوق الوالدين ظلم. عقوق الوالدين. There is no kids most of the time. Being, what can we do in the school and whatever. عقوق الوالدين ظلم. This is your message to give it to your kids. That being ungrateful being bad, being not good, being not thankful. Actually, the word البر in Arabic have no unequal translation. One word will never be enough. But being obeyful and being good and thankful and being submissive to your parent, which it is not allowed now, they call the kids not to be. For that, here is your duty to go against what these viruses. Do you know the injection you give to your kids while they are young against the virus? For that, this is a virus, disease of the akhlaq. You should teach your kids about that. Otherwise, don't expect from them to be good to you when you get old and they are strong. First thing, 18, leave him alone. For that, here, عقوق الوالدين, kind of ظلم also. والظلم لا يصدر إلا عن شخصية لئيمة قبيسه ماكرة منتقمة أحقاد دفينة في قلوبهم حيث ضعف الإيمان وحيث ضعف الوازع الديني والخلق وقسوة قلوبهم وعدم خشية الله. ظلم will never come from a good person. Did you ever hear that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم or any of the messenger doing any kind of ظلم? No, because a good personality. ظلم always coming from I have no literal translation, but the crooked one, the one who have disease in his heart, the one who is evil, the one who is wicked, the one who have no iman, no strong iman, because the iman prevents that. Iman will prevent all of this garbage, all of these diseases. But if there is no iman, and there is no khuluq, and heart is like a stone, have no any mercy in it. For that, this kind, the one who does not fear Allah Azza wa Jal, is the all of zulm come from this kind of people. والظلم تجاوز من الحق إلى الباطل من الصحيح إلى الخطأ. ظلم always for leaving the حق, leaving the right to the false, to the wrong, leaving the good to the bad, leaving the light to the dark, will never be in any good in any shape. وترك العدل واتباع الهوى. ظلم is leaving the justice and following your own desire, bad and evil desire. والتخبط في طرق التسلط والقهر. And also going in the darkness against the people and doing oppression and doing wrong against the people because of some Allah giving you of the power and Allah is able to take it from you. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا. اللهم كفر عنا سيئاتنا. اللهم توفنا مع الأبرار. اللهم أرحنا وافرحنا واسترنا ولا تفضحنا. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين فوق كل أرض وتحت كل سماء يا رب العالمين. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم طهر قلوبنا من الغل والحقد والحسد. اللهم طهر قلوبنا من الغل والحقد والحسد. وارزقنا قلوبا تقية نقية لا كافرة ولا شقية. وأعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك يا رب العالمين. اللهم من مكر بنا فانكر به واجعل مكرهم يحيق بهم ويدمرهم تدميرا. واجعل مكر أولئك هو يبور. واجعل كيدهم في تضليل وتباب. واصرفهم وابعدهم وانقلهم واخزهم وأرح العباد والبلاد والشجر والدواب منهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الذي إذا دعيت به أجب وإذا سئلت به أعطيت. أنصر من نصرنا واخذل من خذلنا واكفنا شر كل ذي شر أنت آخذ بناصيته يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا وأهالينا وبلادنا وبلاد المسلمين في ضمانك وأمانك وإحسانك وحفظك ورعايتك ونصرك وتأييدك يا رب العالمين. وابسط في بلاد المسلمين بسط الخير والأمن والنور والهدى والإيمان يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. وجنبنا وجنب بلاد المسلمين أسباب الأذى والفتن والمحن والحروب والشرور يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. وصل اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وجزاكم الله خيرا.